Hello friends, in my this video I am going to discuss one very interesting digital signal processing related question from MATLAB Codi. Okay, see here I have opened MathWorks and this is problem 2228, which is basically time expansion related problem which you already might have studied in your signals and systems or digital signal processing course. Okay, so see, the question is very simple. The same concept whatever we apply in time expansion, that's only is given as problem statement in this particular question. And the question is, how can you slow down any discrete time signal? For example, obviously discrete time signal, because in MATLAB you cannot deal with continuous time. Any signal, whether it is continuous or discrete, that is handled as discrete signal only in MATLAB, because the processor can never form actual continuous signal. If you want to make continuous signal, that means the sampling interval should be very less. In that way, the discrete signal can be realized some closer approximation of continuous signal, right? So anyway, so how can you slow down any discrete time signal, that is time expansion of a particular signal? Suppose input original signal or sequence is given as 1, 2, 3, minus 1, minus 2, minus 5, and minus 4. Then we want to slow down n equal to 3 times original signal, then the output will be C. Like this, your output signal should be, that is, in between two successive samples of your input signal or input sequence or input discrete time signal, as we are slowing down by n equal to 3, so 3 minus 1, that is 2 zeros has to be inserted. Like here, see the output sequence 1 0 0. 2 0 0, 3 0 0, minus 1 0 0, minus 2 0 0, minus 5 0 0, minus 4, like that. Okay, so that's what we have to do. Obviously in discrete time signal, if you do time expansion, that's what we follow. That is, suppose x of, from x of n we are converting to x of, suppose we are making time expansion, and that is x of n by 3, then what we do, 3 minus 1, that is 2, so 2 zeros we pad in between two successive samples. But one thing you observe, after the last sample, here it was minus 4 in the input, same thing we are following in the output also, minus 4. Okay, that is, after minus 4 we are not padding, that is, for just you have to add zeros in between two successive samples, not in the corners. Okay, so what to do, very simple. See here I have written the code. So first line is CLC, then clear all, then close all. You can write warning off also, no issue in that. Then x equal to input, enter the signal or enter the sequence or enter the discrete time signal, you can write. Then k equal to input the required amount, amount, sorry for the spelling mistake, amount of expansion. Okay, then y, we have defined one empty matrix to store the output matrix, and j equal to k minus 1, because as you know, if you are converting from y of n to y of n by some value, suppose n by 3, then 2 zeros we pad, right? That is 3 minus 1 is 2, so that variable I am storing in j, that is j is equal to k minus 1. Okay, sorry, here this will be j. So now for I equal to 1 colon length of x, that is, the loop will, the for loop will start from first position of our input array and it will go to our last index position of the input array. So I equal to 1 colon length of x, first directly insert the element, so y equal to y x of y, then x of I, we are inserting the first element. Then if I not equal to length of x, that is, if the index position is not corresponding to the last index position of our input array, then what we are doing, for m equal to 1 colon j, y equal to y0, that is, we are inserting k minus 1 number of zeros in the y array. Then we are ending this internal for loop, one more end for this if condition, and this last end is for this for loop. Okay, so I hope you have understood this program. Anyway, I will post the same program in the description. If you want, you can check. So let me show you the simulation. So control A, evaluate selection. Okay, now let us directly go to our test case signal. Suppose 1, 2, 3, minus 1, minus 2, minus 5, minus 4. So 1, 2, 3, minus 1, minus 5. What was the signal? Minus 1, minus 2, minus 5, minus 4. Okay, so here this is minus 2, then minus 5, then minus, sorry, I have printed wrong sequence, let me check once. So 1, 2, 3, minus 1, minus 2, minus 5, minus 4. Okay, let us check once more. Yep. So now you just click enter and enter the required amount of expansion 3. Now you write capital Y and enter. See 100 200 300 -100 -200 -500 -4. Okay, so if it is exactly matching with our Kodi problem statement. Let us check for one more signal, suppose 7 8 9, and suppose the required amount of expansion is 4, that is 4 minus 1 is equal to 3 zeros has to be padded or inserted in between each samples. See, you write capital Y and enter 7 0 0 0 8 0 0 0 and 9. So which is perfectly working for time expansion case. This may help you in your digital signal processing related course also. You have to do this kind of signal manipulation, you will understand in detail. Okay, so this is all for this video. I hope you have understood the concept. If you have any doubt, you can ask in the comment section. Thank you for watching.